and gentlemen, I'm happy to join you once again and to have the opportunity to address the 2015 May Parade. As we are all aware, the 1st of May, Wednesday, is an important day on the Wednesday's global calendar. For us in Ghana, we celebrate this day excitedly because we need to celebrate the enormous contributions that our labor and our sacrifices have made to our dear country Ghana over the years. This is because through our investment in the work and the infrastructure, we are changing lives, improving living conditions, and making progress in transforming our country's economy. Honorable Chairman, I congratulate you and your executive for your comments on this year's theme, addressing the energy crisis and the role of organized labor. Indeed, this year you will not have selected a more appropriate theme than this one, considering the current energy challenges our nation is facing. Ladies and gentlemen, this is yet another testimony of the growing confidence and trust that must exist between us, government, and the organized labor. Because it means that we will have a role to play in preparing this energy crisis as soon as possible. Ladies and gentlemen, this is also a manifestation of the healthy and genuine desire of organized labor to contribute to the resolution of the power supply shortfall. I wish to assure you that we are working to strategically and permanently fix the generation and distribution shortfall that we are currently experiencing. The power sector has and receive three fresh updates from the Minister MC. And I'm confident that we are making every effort to overcome the power crisis we are going through in the shortest possible time. My comrades and friends, as I have indicated, we do not intend to manage ourselves out of the crisis. It is our intention to put in a mix of both emergency and a planned generation from both public and private sources until we ultimately have enough supply to meet our demand. Our current challenge is not because we do not have money or someone is refusing to buy good oil to power the thermal plants as some people have us believe. As I speak, our generation from Abuasi, from Okapo and Ituro, and for the past 2 weeks, we've been relying on light crude oil because of the shutdown of the Ghana gas plant at Ituro for maintenance. Our inability to fully utilize installed capacity in Abuasi has been due to technical problems with the plant rather than an absence of crude oil. Happily, we are overcoming those technical challenges, and as the thermal plant in Abuasi ramp up to full capacity in the next few days, we should feel a visible relief from this dreadful load management crisis we have been going through. In terms of both the Senate plant and the PRA, the thermal plant are currently running on light crude oil. The current gas volumes in the West African gas pipeline is not enough, and therefore only the assembly plant is utilizing it for power generation at a reduced capacity. To overcome the unpredictable nature of gas supply in the thermal enclave, government is entering into a contract for an emergency closing storage regasification unit. To be able to meet energy and natural gas into the system. This is particularly important as the nearly 550 megawatts of power from the new thermal plants and assembly place two are nearing completion and commissioning. And by the time we commission this plant, we should be able to supply a gas. As I said in the video for the Minister of Finance, I am confident in the assurance given by my Minister of Power that if you see gradual improvement in the system, as more power kicks in, and we expect that you should achieve a complete end to load shedding by the end of this year. Businesses are not being automated, but are rather